Hello viewers, my name is Dr. Ajay Kishan, Associate Professor, Working Associate Professor in the Department of ECE, IR Engineering College, Hyderabad. Today, we are going to discuss the topic from antennas, waves and propagation, that is dielectric lens antenna, zoning and tolerance of the lens antenna. So, today's topic is about zoning and tolerance of lens antenna, and let us start our session today. So, as we have seen yesterday about a brief about the lens antenna. So, in the lens antenna, there are two properties mainly in the transmitting antenna and the receiving antenna. So, in the transmitting antenna, the divergence property is applied, and in the receiving antenna, the convergence property is applied in the lens antenna. Let us start today with some types of lens antenna. That is, there are two types of lens antenna. One is a non-metallic dielectric lens antenna, and also metallic dielectric lens antenna. So here today we'll discuss about the non-metallic dielectric lens antenna. In the display you can see here there is a lens antenna where O is taken as the focal point here, and here D is the radius of the curvature of the lens antenna. R represents the radius with respect to the D to the point P here, you can see here, and AB, it is the aperture dimension of the lens antenna, the open mouth of the lens antenna. And here there are two asymptotes here. One is this path and this is another path. There are two asymptotes here, and let us derive an expression to find out the equation of the shape of the lens antenna. Here the primary antenna, which may be the point source, is located exactly at the focal point of the lens antenna, at point O. Here OD represents the axis of the lens antenna. OD represents the axis of the lens antenna. Here let us define the path length. That is, what is the path length here? As the electromagnetic rays propagate from the point O, it will travel from point O to P to P dash, or it may also travel from O to S to Q dash, S to Q dash. So, according to the equality of the path lengths, as per in the display, you can see here, the path OP P dash will be equivalent to the path OS Q dash. The path OP P dash will be equivalent to the path OS Q dash. That means the electrical path length of these two paths will be equal at the open mouth of the lens antenna. Here, let us join this point O and P. Let us define this SQ as small parameter by X variable. Let us define the variable SQ distance by the variable small x. And here, the path PQ, you can see here, PQ is equal to P dash and Q dash. The path length PQ is equivalent to P dash and Q dash. And here the total length, that means the total length from OQ dash, the total length OQ dash, the total length OQ will be equivalent to OS plus SQ. OS plus SQ. That means the total length OS is defined as a variable L, and also the SQ length is defined as a variable X. So OQ is equal to L plus X. This is from the figure which is displayed on the screen. And let us assume theta be the angle, that is angle POQ. Let us define by angle POQ is equal to some angle theta, some angle theta. Here, it is designed by the ray analysis methods of geometrical optics, as dielectric lens is identical to the optical lens. So, as we know that the lens antenna is made up of some material like lucite, and this, the properties of the dielectric lens antenna is equivalent to the optical lens antenna. So, the ray analysis method, that means the ray path methods, are applied to this dielectric lens antenna. So, if this lens antenna is to convert a spherical wavefront from a source placed at a focus F to a plane wavefront, from them all the ray paths from O to the plane surface AB of the lens should have equal electric length. So, here if you observe here, if this is the lens antenna, let us take this focal point F here. Let us assume this point as O. All the lengths that travel and touch the surface of the lens will be having equivalent ray paths, will be having the length of all the rays will be equal. That means if you assume this AB, if you assume the plane surface of the lens as AB, so all these path lengths OA and OC and OB will be equal. So this is the principle of equality of path lengths. This is the principle of equality of path lengths. So here this optical source, here at the focal point, we are going to place a point source here, a point source. So from this point source, all the spherical waves are going to touch the surface of the lens, and a plane wavefront is formed at the plane surface of the lens antenna. That means a spherical wavefront is being converted into a plane wavefront by the lens antenna. So according to the principle of equality of path lengths, all the paths from the source to the plane surface of the lens should be equal to, so field over entire plane surface in the phase. So all the electromagnetic rays which travel from the point source to the plane surface of the lens, all will be in phase and the lens will be equal. Hence, the wave emerging from source will have constant phase aperture d if the lens is so shaped that the time taken by a ray to travel from O to aperture plane AB is the same for all the possible ray paths. That means, you can see here, the time taken by this OA ray will be equivalent to the time taken by the OB ray. Here there is, this is ray 1 and this is ray 2. So this is one path, this is another path. And this is R3, this is ray path 3. So all these ray paths R1, R2, R3, the time taken by all these paths to reach the plane surface AB will be equal and are in phase, and are in phase. So let us assume the velocity of the wave is traveling in two different mediums. One is free space, this is the free space. So this is the free space and this is another medium. This is the lens medium, this is medium 2 and this is medium 1. So let us assume the velocity of the electromagnetic wave that is traveling in free space, or air as C. And let us assume the velocity of the electromagnetic ray that is traveling inside the lens medium as V. So C is defined free space and V is defined as velocity in the lens medium, in the lens medium. So we are going to define by two different variables, C and V, the velocity of wave in the air, the velocity of the wave in the medium. So as per the figure, you can see here, OP plus PP dash is equal to OS plus SQ dash. So OP plus PP dash is equal to OS plus SQ dash. So you can see in the figure, here, OP plus PP dash is equal to, see here, this part OP plus PP dash is equal to OS plus SQ dash. So here you can also write this SQ dash, you can also write this SQ dash as OS plus SQ plus QQ dash. So from the figure you can write OP plus PP dash is equal to OS plus SQ dash. So here this OQ dash can be, OP plus PP dash is equal to OS plus SQ dash. So this can be modified as OS plus SQ dash is equal to SQ plus QQ dash, SQ plus QQ dash. But we know that from the figure, you can see here, PP dash is equal to QQ dash. PP dash is equal to QQ dash. So you can substitute, replace this term by PP dash. So plus SQ plus OS. So both sides PP dash and PP dash get cancelled. The remaining terms are OP is equal to OS plus SQ. So here the OP length is given by the variable, R. And OS is defined by the variable L and SQ is defined by the variable X. You can see here. So R is equal to L plus S. So this is one expression which we got from this dielectric lens antenna. Here R is equal to some distance of OP which is defined as L plus X. So this is OP is equal to OS plus SQ. So here OP means R is equal to L, SQ is equal to X. So from the figure we got R is equal to L plus X. And here, let us define OP is equal to OS plus SQ. So, OP is equal to OS plus SQ here. So, let us define what is the time taken by the path ray. What is the time taken by the each path ray to reach to the plane surface of the lens antenna. See here, OP is equal to OS plus SQ. Let us find out what is the time taken by TOP. That means TOP represents here the time taken by the OP path to reach to the lens antenna. Here we know that speed is equal to, we know that speed is equal to distance by time. We know that speed is equal to distance by time. Or we can also write T is equal to, from this equation, T is equal to, we can write D by S. We can write as D by S. So what is D here? D represents the distance. D represents the distance D. The distance is the distance traveled by the OP path. So here the distance is R. So you can see here the OP path distance is R by velocity. Here we have defined the velocity in the free space as C and inside the medium as V. So here the speed becomes C. That means TOP is equal to R by C. TOP is equal to R by C. Similarly, let us define the expression TOS. Let us define the expression TOS. So what is the time taken by the path OS to travel from the point O to the lens medium? That means TOS. So what is the TOS? Again, we are going to find out the time taken. That means distance by speed. What is the distance taken by the OS? It is, the distance is L and the speed is, we have calculated as C here. So TOS is equal to L by C. And similarly, let us find out the equation SQ. What is SQ? TSQ. So TSQ is equal to D by S. The distance traveled. The distance traveled by velocity. Here we are going to define the distance as SQ is equal to X. The speed taken, that means the velocity of the wave inside the medium, we have defined by the variable V here. So we got TOS is equal to L by C and TSQ is equal to X by V and TOP is equal to R by C. So all we have defined. So what is OP here? Here OP is equal to R is equal to L plus X. OP is equal to R plus X. So what is the time taken by TOP? So let us find out the time taken by the OP, the time taken by the OS and the time taken by the SQ. So T, we have defined the equation as R is equal to L plus X. And from this expression, the time taken, so the time taken by the path OP will be equivalent to the total summation of the times taken by the OS path and also the SQ path. So here we can find out from this expression, L by C is equal to TOP is equal to R by C. So TOP is equal to R by C. This is equal to L by C plus X by V. X by V. So this is the expression we got here. So you can further simplify this by taking the C as a constant here. From this expression, you can find out R by C is equal to L by C. And here you can find out the value of X here. So R by C is equal to L by C plus X by V here. And if you take the C as a C by V as a common, you will get L plus C by V into X. And C by V is defined as the refractive index mu here. So R is equal to L plus mu X. So R is equal to L plus mu X. So from this equation, we got, so R is equal to L plus mu X, where mu is equal to C by V. Where mu is equal to C by V. So C by V is nothing but the refractive index. We are defining by some variable mu. So mu, the refractive index, it is defined as the ratios of the velocities of one medium to the velocity of the other medium. We call it as a refractive index, which is defined by the variable mu. So R is equal to L plus mu X here. And let us define, let us further simplify to find out the value of X in terms of theta value. So in terms of theta, we can also define this value. You can see on the display here, what is the value of cos theta? So from the figure, you can see here, cos theta, if you take the triangle O, P and Q, if you take the triangle O, P, Q, what is cos theta here? Cos theta is equal to, adjacent side to theta. So adjacent side to theta is equal to OQ by hypotenuse OP. So what is OQ here? OQ is nothing but OS plus SQ. So OS is defined as L plus SQ is defined as X by OP is defined as R. This is cos theta. This is cos theta. So from this equation, we get x equal to r cos theta minus L. So from this equation, we get x equal to r cos theta minus L. So we need to substitute this x value in this expression. That is, r is equal to L plus mu x. So x equal to r cos theta minus L. So which we got from the triangle OP and Q. So this, so finally, if you simplify by substituting the value of x in terms of theta from the figure, you can see here, from the figure, if you substitute cos theta is equal to OQ by R, that is equal to OS plus SQ by R, that is equal to OS plus X by R. So from this equation, you will get the value of x. So R is equal to L plus mu R cos theta minus mu L. If you take further substitution, if you further simplify, if you get take this mu L to one side, take R as common. If you take R as common, you will get 1 minus mu cos theta, that is equal to L into 1 minus mu. So here R is equal to L into mu minus 1 by mu cos theta minus 1. So this is the equation of the hyperbola or equation of the shape of the lens antenna. So finally, we got the expression R is equal to L into mu minus 1 by mu cos theta minus 1, which represents the equation of the shape of the lens antenna or non-metallic dielectric lens antenna. So this equation, we can also call it as the equation of the hyperbola. The equation of the hyperbola or equation of the shape of the lens antenna, or we can also define, that is, the principle of, from the principle of equality of path lens, the length of the radius of the lens is given by R is equal to L into mu minus 1 by mu cos theta minus 1. So what are the advantages of a lens antenna? So here, the following are the advantages of the lens antenna. In lens antenna, the feed and the feed support do not obstruct the aperture. The feed and the feed support do not obstruct the aperture. That means a plane wavefront can be achieved from the lens antenna. That means the electromagnetic waves are not diverged in different directions into free space. All the electromagnetic rays which touch the lens antenna, they pass into the medium and they come in parallel from the open mouth of the lens antenna. And it has a greater design tolerance. It has a greater design tolerance. That means it depends upon the design of the lens antenna, depends upon the thickness of the lens antenna or the thickness of the medium of the lens antenna and the material we use in the medium. Larger amount of wave than a parabolic reflector can be handled. So a parabolic reflector, there is a loss of energy is more compared to the lens antenna. So most of the energy is consumed in the lens medium. Hence, most of the amount of energy is not being wasted in the lens antenna. So beam can be moved angularly with respect to the axis. So we can change the direction of the lens antenna according to our requirements. That means the beam can be moved, the angular beam can be moved with respect to the axis as per requirements according to the application. So these are the disadvantages of the lens antenna. So these lenses are very heavy and bulky, especially at lower frequencies. So these lenses can be used effectively only in the ultra high frequency and also the very high frequency ranges only. And also these lenses are heavy and bulky, and due to this heavy and bulky, we cannot carry this lens antenna from longer distances. For longer distances, it is not very easy task for us to carry the lenses antenna. So the complexity in design. The design of the lens antenna is very complex when compared to the parabolic reflector or a dipole antenna. It is very costly compared to the reflectors for the same specifications. So though the parabolic reflector for a 300 megahertz, and if you use a lens 300 megahertz, the specifications are same. So we are going to use the input signal as 300 megahertz to the parabolic reflector antenna, and also 300 megahertz frequency range in the lens antenna. So when we design both these antennas, we can, by comparison, we can say that the lens antenna is more costlier than the parabolic reflector antenna. Hence, these parabolic reflectors are widely used in for in most of the home, in most of the public in the daily life. So these lenses are not preferable. Why? Because it's very difficult to carry to one place to another place, and also for the same specification for the application, the design of this lens antennas were much costlier compared to the other antennas. The applications of lens antenna, especially used for microwave frequency applications, and also used as wideband antennas. So used as wideband antennas, and also especially used for microwave frequency applications. These are the basic applications of the lens antenna. The next topic which we are going to discuss is zoning. The next topic is zoning. So what is zoning? So what is, why we are going for a zoning of the lens antenna? So generally, the lens antennas, it is very complex to design the lens antenna, and also the cost of the lens antenna is more, and at the same time it is difficult for us to carry the lens antenna as it is very bulky, as it is heavy weight. It is very difficult for us to carry the lens antenna from one place to the other place. So in such a case, we need to reduce the lens of the antenna. So the weight of the reduction of the lens, the reduction of the weight of the lens antenna by removing some sections of the lens is known as zoning of the lens. Just reduction of the weight of the lens antenna by removing some portion of the lens antenna, we call it as zoning of the lens antenna. And whenever we are going to cut the lens antenna, so removing sections of lens is nothing but cutting the lens antenna. So cutting the lens antenna or removing some small portion of the lens antenna. So there must be some careful design has to be made in such a way that the performance must not be affected. So the performance of the conventional lens antenna and the performance of the lens antenna of the after zoning must not get affected. So here, zoning can be classified as curved surface zoning and plane surface zoning. So you can see here, this is known as curved surface zoning, and this is known as plane surface zoning. So here, you can see here T represents the thickness. Here also T represents the thickness of the plane surface zoning. And this is known as one step zone. So this is known as zone, or this is known as zone in case of curved surface. This is one zone. So you can cut the lens of the antenna. You can specify any number of zones in a lens antenna. So there is no any limitation that there must be only 2 zones or 3 zones or 4 zones. Right? So depending upon the application, depending upon the reduction of the lens, depending upon the reduction of the weight of the lens antenna, see that the performance of the lens antenna is not affected. In such a way, we need to zone the lens antenna. We need to decide how many zones must be made for the specific application. In general, zoning of lens is carried out in such a way that the particular design frequency of performance of the lens antenna is not affected. The zone step is denoted by the T. So here, the zoning of the lens is carried out in such a way that the performance of the lens antenna must not be affected. Here, the step of zone, or the zone step of the lens antenna, is denoted by the symbol T. So in zone lens antenna, the thickness T of the lens antenna is such that the electrical length of the thickness T in dielectric is an integral length of lambda longer than in A. Here, the basic design of the lens antenna, see that the thickness must be equivalent to lambda by mu minus 1, where mu is equal to C by V. C is nothing but the velocity in the free space, V is the velocity inside the medium. So whenever we are going to design the antenna, this expression has to be used to define the thickness of the lens antenna, where T is thickness or the zoning portion of the lens antenna, where T is given by lambda by mu minus 1. So these are the differences between the curved surface zoning and the plane surface zoning. So there are two types. One is curved surface zoning. The other one is, see here, you can have, this is known as curved surface zoning, and this is known as plane surface zoning. So when compared to the curved surface zoning, plane surface zoning, the curved surface zoning, it is having a less weight compared to the plane surface zoning. Right? So the curved surface zoning, the weight is very less, compared to the plain surface zoning. The plain surface zoning, it is very heavy and it bulkier. So it is not such an easy task for us to carry, even after zoning also. This is a plain surface zoning lens antenna. We cannot carry to longer distances. So as it is heavy weight and bulkier. And curved surface zoning, it is mechanically stronger than plain surface zoning. So the curved surface zoning, it is mechanically stronger when compared to the plain surface zoning. Also, the power dissipation is less, the power dissipation is more. So the power dissipation in the curved surface zoning is less. So power dissipation is more in the plain surface zoning. So from these two differences, we can conclude that the curved surface zoning is more preferred than plain surface zoning. So whenever you want to carry it for longer distances, whenever you want to carry the lens antenna for longer distances, curved surface zoning is the most preferable method in the lens antenna. Why? Because it is less weight and also it is mechanically stronger than the plain surface zoning. So this is about the zoning of the lens antenna. Let us go for the next topic, that is tolerance of the lens antenna. The tolerance of the lens antenna. So generally, so why we are going for tolerance of the lens antenna? So the whenever we are going to design a lens antenna, see that the design must not affect the performance of the lens antenna. Sometimes after 1 year or 2 years or 3 years, there may be some variation in the thickness of the lens antenna. So here, if suppose the design is not proper, suppose like this, the design is there. That means there is a curve in the lens medium. You can see here, this is the conventional lens antenna. You can see here, this is the proper lens antenna. And here you can see here, the design is improper, like this. Here, there is a curve here. Here, there is no curve here. One, you can observe 1 and 2 here. So, 1 is the conventional lens antenna. And 2, it is the lens antenna which we have designed. And after 1 year or 2 years, there is some problem in the lens antenna. That means there is some deviation in the thickness. So, whenever there is any deviation in the thickness of the lens antenna, the refractive index will vary. So, that means the path length of the electromagnetic waves that are traveling inside the medium will reach to the plane surface of the lens antenna at a different time interval. That means here, if this is a point source, this OF path will reach earlier and this OB path will reach earlier than the path OC. Why? Because there is some deviation in the thickness of the lens medium at the OC point. So the OA and OB will be equal. The OA path will be equal to OB, but is not equal to OC path. So here, the performance is affected due to the variation in the thickness and variation in the index of refraction. So there might be some manufacturer defects in the lens medium also, in the lens antenna also. So as we use more time this lens antenna, the thickness is affected. Hence, at some areas, the thickness is reduced than the previous one. So here, sometimes the lens antenna might, as you can see here, sometimes the lens may be like this. The lens antenna medium is affected. That means the thickness is variable. The thickness is not constant in a regular fashion. Right? Here there is one type of thickness. Here there is another type of thickness. Right? Hence, the electrical path length will vary. So here, if the electrical path length vary to a maximum extent, then it is defined as the tolerance of the lens antenna. That means the performance is more affected. If the thickness of the lens antenna is very less, if the variation in the thickness of the lens antenna is very less and minute, then the performance is not affected. But if the thickness of the lens medium, is variable, then the performance is affected. See here, the thickness of the tolerance has more impact on the thickness of the medium of the lens antenna has more impact on the performance of the lens antenna. Right? So what must be the thickness of the tolerance? That means there is one deviation in the thickness, there is one variation in the index of refraction. Right? So here, let us assume the maximum allowable variation in both the parameters to be lambda naught by 32. Right? So if this deviation in the thickness or variation in the index of refraction is greater than lambda naught by 32, then the performance of the lens antenna is more affected. If the thickness in the deviation or the variable in the refractive index is greater than the value of lambda naught by 32, then that lens antenna can be ignored. That means the performance, as the performance of lens antenna reduces more. That is, the performance of the lens antenna is affected more here. Here, what must be, this is the maximum tolerance of the thickness, deviation the thickness. It must not be greater than 1 by 32. Hence here, you can see here, the thickness of the tolerance, it is given by del t by lambda d minus del t by lambda naught, that equal to 1 by 32. So, del t by lambda d minus del t by lambda naught is equal to 1 by 32 here. So, this is the maximum allowable variation in the deviation in the thickness. The maximum allowable variation in the variation in the thickness is given by delta d by lambda d minus del t by lambda naught is equal to 1 by 32. Here, lambda naught represents the free space wavelength. Free space wavelength. And lambda d represents the wavelength inside the medium. The wavelength inside the medium, inside the lens medium, it is given by lambda d. And lambda naught represents free space wavelength. Free space wavelength is given by lambda naught. And del t represents the deviation of the thickness. T is known as the thickness of the lens medium. And del t is known as the variation in the thickness of the lens medium. Variation in the thickness of the lens medium. So, you can see here, n is equal to index of refraction given by lambda naught by lambda d. So, here, the free space wavelength and the lens medium. Free space wavelength, the ratios of free space wavelength to the lens medium. So, this is given as the wave is traveling from one medium to the other medium. So, here you can see here, this is the lens antenna. The wave is traveling in the free space and this wave is traveling inside the medium. This is another medium, lens medium. Right? So, we are going to define the wave, one wave as a lambda naught and this wave as a lambda d. This wave as the lambda d. So, here lambda naught by lambda d, if you substitute here, lambda d is equal to, you can from this equation, lambda d is equal to lambda naught by n. Lambda d is equal to lambda naught by n. You substitute this lambda naught by n in here, in the earlier expression, you can see here, this value here. So, n is equal to, you can see here, n is equal to lambda naught, n is equal to lambda naught by lambda d. Or we can also from this equation, lambda d is equal to lambda naught by n. Lambda d is equal to lambda naught by n. Now you substitute this equation in this expression, you will get del t by lambda naught by n minus del t by lambda naught is equal to 1 by 32. So from this, if you further simplify here, you will get n del t by lambda naught minus del t by lambda naught is equal to 1 by 32. So, from this equation, if you further simplify, you will get the value of del t. That means, the deviation, the thickness in terms of a free space wavelength. In terms of a free space wavelength. So, if you substitute here, see here, you can substitute here, you will get n del t by lambda naught minus del t by lambda naught is equal to 1 by 32. Now, take this del t and lambda naught out, you will get del t is equal to lambda naught by 32 into n minus 1. So, del t is equal to lambda naught by 32 into n minus 1. So, here n represents the refractive index which is given by lambda naught by lambda d. So, n is represented as the ratios of the free space wavelength to the electromagnetic ray wavelength inside the medium. It is given by lambda naught by lambda d. So, if you substitute, further simplify this 1 by 32, if you divide this 1 with 32, you will get the value of 0.03. So, 1 by 32 is equal to 0.03. You will get 0.03 into lambda naught by n minus 1. Let us take a special case by substituting some random values to see the performance of the lens antenna. Let us assume the thickness as n is thickness as 0.06 lambda naught. Right, the variation in the thickness of the lens antenna is, let us assume a value 0.06 lambda naught, where the refractive index of the lens medium is given as 1.5, which is greater than 1. like 1 or 1.2 or 1.3 or some take some random value as 1.5. We substitute these two values here, what you will get? The thickness of the lens medium. So if you test, if you substitute this n value as a 1.5 and a del t is equal to 0.06 lambda naught. Now the tolerance of n is, it is given by, so you will get here, if n is equal to if you substitute here n is equal to 1.5, so 1.5 minus 1 is equal to 1 by is equal to 0.5, and 32 into 0.5 you will get here, and del t is equal to, substitute these values here, you will get value as, see here, del t is equal to 0.06 lambda naught by n minus 1, so n is equal to 1.5 is equal to, you will get 0.5 divided by, and 0.03 lambda naught is equal to del t. Okay, so we'll get the value as 0.03, means you'll get around 0.006 lambda naught is equal to del t. So this is just an example that in such a way that if the value of n is equal to 1.5 and del t is equal, del t will be equivalent to 0.06 lambda naught. Okay, so if the refractive index of the material, it is the refractive index of the material, it is, if you substitute here, if you substitute n is equal to 1.5 here, so 1.5 minus 1 is equal to 0.5, and if you simplify, this is 0.5 is 0.03, you will get del t is equal to 0.06 into lambda naught. So here, for this assumption, the refractive index of the material, if the refractive index of the material is 1.5, then the maximum deviation in the thickness of the lens medium must not be greater than 0.06 lambda naught. So if it is greater than 0.06 lambda naught, what happens? Right, so if the thickness and the deviation in the thickness of the lens medium, it is greater than 0.06 lambda naught, then the performance of the lens antenna is more affected. So this is one of the design parameter or the design constraint while designing the lens antenna. Now the tolerance of n, we can also write in terms of a combination of a refractive index and the thickness, right? So one is the tolerance depends upon the deviation. The other one is the tolerance depends upon the refractive index mu or n. Right? This is one constraint. The other one is another constraint. So one is deviation in the thickness. The other one is refractive index of the medium. And here, in the second case, if you come to the second case, change in the variation in the refractive index of the lens medium, we can write the expression as del n of t is equal to lambda naught by 32. That means the variation in the refractive index must not be greater than lambda naught by 32. Must not be greater than lambda naught by 32. So if you further simplify this, del n is equal to lambda naught by 32 t, and bring this lambda naught to denominator, you will get t by lambda naught. Let us assume this t by lambda naught. Let us assume this t by lambda naught as t lambda. Let us assume this t by lambda naught as t lambda. So t by lambda naught is equal to 1 by 32 into t lambda. If you simplify this 1 by 32 value, you will get 0.03. You will get 0.03 by t lambda. So here, where t lambda is equal to t by lambda, the thickness of the lens in the free space wavelength. In the free space wavelength, it is lambda naught. On further simplification, you will get, if you divide the above expression by n, you will get a change in the refractive index. So what means the change in the refractive index is given by the equation del n by n. So if you substitute this value with n and n, substitute, you can multiply the numerator, the denominator by the value of refractive index n, you will get 0.03 into n by t lambda into n. So 0.03 by n t lambda we will get. Right, so in terms of percentage, we can also write this as into 100, if you do here, you will get 3 by n into t lambda percentage. That means change in the refractive index of the material of the medium must not be greater than 3 by n t lambda. Right, the refractive index must not be greater than 3 by n t lambda percentage. If it is greater than, if there is more variation in the refractive index of the material, it exceeds the 3 by n t lambda, then the performance of the lens antenna degrades. It will be reduced gradually. So in case of E-plane metal plate lens, the thickness of the tolerance is given by del T is equal to lambda naught by 32 into 1 minus n, that is equal to 0.03 lambda naught by 1 minus n. So lambda naught by 32 into 1 minus 1, we can also write it as 1 by 32 is equal to 0.03 lambda naught by 1 minus n, where lambda naught represents the free space wavelength, n represents the refractive index of the medium or material. And for the tolerance and the spacing between the plates of the is given by, suppose we can also design antenna by means of plates, metal plates. So that means we can also place like this is one plate and this is the other plate. So like this, if we make here the difference between these two plates is B. Let us assume the spacing between the two plates, the spacing between the two plates is taken as B. Then what must be the deviation in the spacing of the plates? So it is given by the equation del B by B. It is given by the equation del B by B. So let us assume these two as metal plates designed by the lens for the lens antenna here. This is one lens antenna, this is another lens antenna. Let us define some spacing between the plates. This spacing between the plates is B here. So what must be the spacing between the plates which we designed for the lens antenna? That spacing must not exceed 3n by 1 minus n square into t lambda. The spacing B between the plates must not exceed to the value 3n by 1 minus n square into t lambda. So this is about the tolerance. So here today, let us conclude what we have discussed. So what is the lens antenna, what is the zoning, and what is the tolerance? That means reduction of weight of the lens antenna is known as zoning. And the tolerance is defined in two parameters. One is variation in the thickness and also variation in the refractive index, which are given by two expressions. We should not, the deviation in the thickness of the lens antenna must not exceed these values. If the deviation in the thickness and the refractive index exceeds these two values, then the design of the lens antenna becomes improper and the performance is affected and it will be degraded gradually. Okay? Let us close the session. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.